Good morning, Bob.
Good morning.
What are you doing?
I'm packing my backpack. I'm going hiking on the Appalachian Trail. Three of my friends and I decided to go hiking. I need to take everything I need for the trip.
So what are you packing?
Well, I have my tent. You know, we need protection from the weather in case it rains.
That's true. You would be one wet kid if it rains.
That's right. I also have food. A boy's got to eat, you know.
That's right. You need food to give you energy to hike.
I have some clothes, mostly socks. I don't want to walk in wet socks, so I have extra socks to change into so my feet don't get wet and then get blisters.
It sounds like you are prepared to go hiking, Bob.
Oh, wait, and I have this too. That's so I can look really cool.
Look cool to whom? The bears?
Bears! Ah!
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that. To think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done.
Hey, Bob, do you know who provides all those things for you?
My parents?
That's true, too. But there's someone who also provides for everything we need.
Who are you talking about?
I'm talking about God. God provides for our physical needs. That's how much He loves us. Let's hear about how God provided the nation of Israel. Let's listen to a true story from the Old Testament.
Thank you for joining me here in the desert. And, well, I have an amazing story to tell you. Moses led all of us, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. That was after God sent 10 plagues to prove that He was God. It was awesome. Anyway, before we left Egypt, the people of Egypt gave us lots of food and money and told us to go get out of Egypt. They wanted us to go because of all the plagues. That's how I got my Mickey Mouse watch. Anyway, After a few months, the food started to run out, and I was getting really hungry for a Happy Meal, but there was no food. And so we talked to Moses and said, "Moses, we are hungry." And so Moses prayed to God, and you know what happened? God sent food down from heaven every day. We called it manna. And so God provided food for lots and lots and lots of people every day. God provided for our physical need for food. You can read about my story in Exodus chapter 16. Yeah, and it was awesome how God provided all that food. Man, you should have seen my neighbor eat. Man, he would eat and eat and eat and eat. Yeah, he is Jesse Ben Hadad. Yeah, that was his name. But yeah, ye sure love to eat. We are so thankful that God provided food for us. God is a good God. Sweet! God was really good to the children of Israel. He provided food every day.
Yes, he was. Now I want you to listen to another true Bible story about how God provided for one of his prophets. This true story can be found in 1 Kings 17.
Thank you for joining me by the brook Kerith. I'm Elijah. Well, after I told wicked King Ahab that it wasn't going to rain, he wasn't a happy camper. So God told me to get out of town and go to the brook Kerith. And so I took off and came to the brook Kerith down in this ravine. And I was wondering, how am I going to eat out here? But God did an amazing thing. Yeah, he sent ravens with food. Wow, what do you think about that? God sent food by the ravens, and every day God provided food for me. Isn't that awesome? God provides for our physical needs. If you would like to read my whole story, you can find it in 1 Kings 17. Okay? That's in the Old Testament. But you can find my story in 1 Kings 17 and see how God fed me with the ravens bringing me food. Wow, what a story! But I don't think I would like ravens bringing me food.
I'm sure it wasn't as bad as you think. But just think, God provided all the food that Elijah needed. Jesus also talked about food and clothes.
Now, he probably told the people where to buy the best clothes.
No, I don't think so.
So, what did Jesus say about clothes and food?
Well, we need to look at the time Jesus was on a mountainside and spoke to many people. The truth story can be found in Matthew 6.
The book of Matthew is in the New Testament.
That's right, Bob. Listen to the words of Jesus in Matthew 6. That is why I tell you not to worry about everyday life, Whether you have enough food or drink or enough clothes to wear, isn't life more than food and your body more than clothing? Look at the birds. They don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, for your heavenly Father feeds them, and you aren't far more valuable to them than they are. All your worries can add a single moment to your life. And why worry about your clothing? Look at the lilies of the field and how they grow. They don't wear or make their clothing, yet Solomon in all his glory was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for wildflowers that are here today and thrown into the fire tomorrow, he will certainly care for you. Why do you have so little faith? So don't worry about these things, saying, what will we eat? What will we drink? What will we wear? These things dominate our thoughts of unbelievers, but your heavenly Father already knows all your needs. Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need.
Couldn't go to McDonald's, God fed them manna in the desert. He provided food every day for lots of people to eat.
And who was the prophet that God fed with ravens? Elijah.
Oh, and Jesus gave a message on a mound.
The Sermon on the Mount.
Yeah. That place.
So what did you learn?
That we are to trust God that he will provide for our physical needs like clothes and food, and we don't have to worry about it. And we are to do what Jesus wants us to do.
Hey, boys and girls, Pastor Steve, are you ready to learn today's verse? I hope so. Here it is, Matthew 6, 33. Let's say it together. Oh, wait, let me get out of the way first, and then let's say the verse together.
Matthew 6, 33. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well.
Did you get it? Matthew 6, 33. Tell you what, let's say it again.
Matthew 6, 33. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well.
Thank you for joining me, boys and girls. I hope that you enjoyed today's Sunday school lesson. See you next week.